Ever since we were old enough to look into the sky, each one of us has asked whether there may be other planets like ours. Could there be life, intelligence, civilizations? The field of looking for planets outside our own solar system is known as exoplanetology, and such planets are known as exoplanets. Though astronomers had looked for exoplanets for years, it wasn't until 1988 that we found one. It was then another 7 years before we discovered the first orbiting exoplanet around a sun-like star. Known as 51 Pegasi b, it is 50 light years away in the Pegasus constellation. Its mass and gravity are about 11% more than Earth's, so you'd feel a bit heavier. And traces of water are discovered in the atmosphere. Unfortunately, that's where the similarity ends. Its temperature is over 5,500 Kelvin, meaning it would not be a hospitable place to reside. Last year, astronomers discovered Proxima b, an exoplanet orbiting the star Proxima Centauri, only about 4 light years away. It's about 27% more massive than Earth, and its temperature is likely about 39 degrees below zero. It probably doesn't have an atmosphere due to the strong radiation and the stellar winds, and so is only habitable underground. Trappist I is an ultra-cool dwarf star about 40 light years away. It was very recently discovered that it hosts not just one, but 7 exoplanets. Even more amazing, 3 of them are in the habitable zone, meaning they likely support liquid water and thus life. But how will we ever get there? Yuri Milner's Breakthrough Initiative is planning to send small, wafer-sized starships to these exoplanets. Powered by lasers and traveling at 20% the speed of light, they will take 20 years to reach Proxima b, take pictures, and then another 4 years to send back the images. Since small obstacles, like dust and atoms, would destroy the spacecraft, we will have to send thousands of them to make sure we get the job done.